shed.
Jacko, as ever, there blowing bubbles, but he's not alone. We have a children's act now, and this week, children's charters cropped up all over the place. We prize children so highly, but frankly, children are underachievers, really. Very few of them have been Nobel Prize winners. The only sport they're good at is sack racing, and the best record any of them have ever produced is Grandma by the St. Winifred School Choir, the lead singer of which had a tongue that was too big for her mouth. The only thing children are good at is describing satanic abuse and dying on our tune. And talking of them dying, why should a child's life be intrinsically of more value than an adult's? People talk about children being horrors, but the horror of humanity really does lie there in the black original sin of the newborn heart. He's a horror, is Twee. But as a child, I wasn't just Tweely horrific. I was a 3.5-foot Adolf Eichmann. Racist, sexist, violent, cruel. Innocence isn't something you're born with, it's something you grow into. Adam and Eve, remember, sprouted from the head of God, fully grown.
Sometimes I'll be up kids who get lazy to me.
Yeah? What do you do to them?
Punch them in the face and make them cry.
I'd like to hit her head across that lamppost.
And when would you stop?
When I'm 21.
How old are you now?
11.
11, right, so you'd hit her head on that lamppost for over 10 years. What about anyone else? What's the worst thing that you've done?
Well, in our house, we've been scared, so I pushed my brother down the stairs.
Yeah?
And he got
nose. Yeah, you pushed him all the way down the stairs? What about you? Is there anyone you don't like?
Your
school?
Teacher.
Just
say your
worst. What would you like to do?
Worst. I'd like to hang him.
Better.
Yeah.
What?
When you picked the shoe up, did you like it? Did you enjoy being there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like seeing you cry.
You like seeing you cry? Yeah.
I put you in hospital, that girl Bridget.
How'd you put her in hospital?
I hurt her heart.
Yeah, because she's got a bad
heart. She could wear in the heart?
Yeah.
She's got a bad
and
heart.
And this girl, Samara, put her in heart 3 times.
You kicked her in the heart 3 times?
3 times.
Kicked her in the heart. Disregard the angelic faces and voices and think about what they're saying. And this is whom we're giving new rights and responsibilities to, these midwitch cuckoos. Honestly, listening to them talk, I had half a mind to call Interpol.
The one thing that I have done that's the worst thing is stealing.
Oh yeah, well, where did you do that?
Well, I did that when I was in Ecuador.
In Ecuador?
Yeah.
Really? Where did you do it? Well, what did you steal?
Money.
You stole money in Ecuador?
Yeah.
How much money?
Well, loads.
And while we're on the territory, could we from this moment on have no more talk about protecting children from bad language? Children love swearing. It's their vocabulary.
Why did the man say fuck off to the other man? Because the man said your whole generation is a piss whacker.
Did you get that? Why did the man say fuck off to the other man? Because the man said his whole generation was a piss flapper. And here's the next joke. Yeah, it's a good one. The one thing about kids, though, is they will stick by their friends.
Yeah, I'll beat someone up.
Who?
My friend.
Right, who did you do it to?
My friend Katie.
Is that your nose? Whose nose did you get?
Your mate.
Your mate? Is he still your mate?
No.
But we hold on to our ideal by saying that obviously there'll be one bad apple, a single bully. But no, it's all of them, and they're all eager to hurt. We've just forgotten what we were like.
Sometimes before I gave him a bleeding nose and him a black eye.
And he used to bully them too, no?
Yeah.
But now we're all friends and we're a gang.
Sometimes
nowadays we go round as a little gang, getting our ways with the little kids.
If you come up, if you tell little kids, lick the shoe, if they do it, right, like, as long as they're scared to go, lick it again, if they don't want to hit him.
This little kid called Michael in Gospel Oak, I told him to lick my shoe and he done it.
Really? Was that good? Did you feel good when that happened?
And when they lick my shoe, when they go to lick my shoe, I'll kick them.
The Chancellor, Norman Lamont, threw a party last night for his 50th birthday. Norman actually clocked up the half century 2 weeks ago, but he waited until after the event to celebrate. That's a change from the policy he adopted towards the economic recovery. He's been celebrating that for months, and there's no sign of it ever happening.
The street parties and mass rejoicing that have greeted Jeremy Bates' progress at Wimbledon is very, very, very sad. The sadness is that we so desperately thirst for a homegrown tennis champion, and yet we'll so obviously never have one as long as tennis stays what it is in this country, an entirely middle-class sport. And since when were the middle class a breeding ground for great sportsmen and women? George Best didn't go to Radley. Fatima Whitbread's dad isn't listed in Debrett's. This doesn't matter in classless America or Sweden, but here, the search for potential future Wimbledon winners misses out most of the country. Tennis here is run, remember, by the All England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club. Yeah, that sounds like a fairly unelitist organisation, doesn't it? Only excludes the Welsh, the Scots, the Northern Irish, and anyone who has never played croquet. The All England Club, who complain most loudly about the lack of British tennis stars, and yet are at their happiest harking back to the days when Wimbledon was won by Bunny Austin, and competitors included King Gustav of Sweden and his doubles partner Prince Chichibu, second son of the Emperor of Japan. So what I'm saying is, I don't think it's worth getting excited about any new British tennis player unless he's got Gazza's haircut, a tattoo, loads of gold jewellery, and a hard dog.
Crime figures are up again. Every 6 seconds, there's a crime committed somewhere. 23% more robberies, 20% more burglaries, and a 15% rise overall. The police are clearly unable to hold back this flood of theft and violence. So what's to be done? One man who is particularly well placed to comment on society's descent into criminality is with me tonight. He's neither a Spectator columnist nor a sociologist. He's an armed robber. Dave X, I should stress to the audience watching at home that you're not an actor, you're not Tracy McLeod wearing a balaclava, you have in fact actually done time for several criminal offences.
Yeah, I've done a bit of both, yeah.
Can I ask you, some people say that it's poverty and deprivation that have caused the increase in crime over the last few years. Do you think that's true?
I actually think that there's a lot of arseholes on the streets now, and I actually think they'll just go for it anyway. It's nothing to do with society, you know.
They're just wicked, really.
Yeah, the bastards.
And
I've got to say, I'm a pro, right? I trained. Mm. I did my bit. I did a bit of thieving. I didn't live in a good area. I would never thieve off of my own, if you like. I went to Belgravia, or I went to Eaton Square, and I did, you know, people that got money that have got sense enough to get themselves insured.
So you were redistributing wealth, really?
Of course, yeah.
A latter-day Robin Hood, as it were.
Yeah, I mean, if you... Nowadays, people, right, young'uns steam in. Now, I used to sit in a boozer, right, and everyone knew that I was at it, right?
Yeah.
And the old girls would give me their pension books, and I'd go and do it. And they'd give me £2 and go and get me shopping, Dave, you know. Mm-hmm. And I used to come back with about £50 worth of gear, and they thought I was a good shopper, but of course I was thieving.
They just thought you had an eye for the bargains, but in fact,
exactly.
You were actually raiding a fish in Belgravia.
Yeah, I used to of course I used to, fit them up. And
so you were a sort of social worker and criminal in one?
Robin Hood, if you like, yeah.
Okay. Can I ask, what do you think should be done to help stem the rise in crime now? Do you think we need stiffer sentences?
Definitely. I mean, the old Bill were bastards, but they got a job to do.
Mm-hmm.
And that... I mean, we play a game, right?
Absolutely.
It's my trade. I get out there, I do my job.
Mm-hmm.
Do the crime, do your time. That's it. And everyone gets a shot and you get pulled.
Do you think that for some of the tougher crimes, for example, for child molesters, nonces and rapists, that we should see the return of capital punishment?
Definitely that, but what I'd rather do is lock a child molester or a rapist in a room with a load of women with his hands chained behind his back and see what they did before they hung him. That's what I think.
I see, so you're very much a tough punisher. In that respect,
definitely, I think it's out of order, don't you? Mm.
And what would you
why
do?
Why molest children? You know, I'd just go and thieve banks.
Absolutely. And what crimes do you think are?